Hello, I'm Sneha. In this video, I will show you how to create mosaic of an image in MATLAB with detailed explanation of code. So stay on with me till the end. Let's start by understanding what is mosaic. Mosaic is an image made of so many other images. For example, see this image. It is an arrangement of number of images. If you zoom in, you could see different images. This is called a tail and this is called a thumbnail image. Before implementing in MATLAB, you need some information or things to create mosaic. First, obviously you need an image that you want a mosaic for. Second, you need a thumbnail images, minimum 50 to 80 thumbnails. Note, more thumbnails, more clear the mosaic will be. Third, collect thumbnails in such a way that it match the color of original image. For example, here in this image, there are red, green, black, cream colors. Choose accordingly. Fourth, we use distance formula to measure the closeness between pixel and thumbnail to create a tail. This is main logic behind photo mosaic. Now you are ready to understand the MATLAB implementation. If you like our videos on MATLAB, subscribe to our YouTube channel to get such videos regularly. Let's run the code to understand the code in a better way. This is the image I had selected to do mosaic. This is the photo mosaic of this image. If you zoom in, you can see many other images, but color is similar to the one in the pixel of original image. Now, this is a tail. The image in that tail is thumbnail. Okay. Now, first three lines of code are used just to clear the command window and workspace and to close all the images to start the program fresh. Keep the image which you need mosaic for in the folder where you saved your MATLAB code. And try to keep the thumbnails of the same type and in a separate folder. Save the folder in the image folder. Set thumb ratio. It is the ratio of thumbnails that make up mosaic. And D value and output scale is the parameters to select the suitable tail and its size. The main program begins from here. Read the image that you want mosaic for using imread. These two lines actually calculating size of each thumbnail in order to fit that as tail using thumb ratio. Next block here works to resize the original image. Here, if we just display the original image without resizing it, we will get this. You can observe the size difference. This is because the mosaic photo is made up of thumbnails of ratio, thumb ratio. So if we consider the original image as it is, those ratio of thumbnails could not fit to create a clear mosaic. So resizing it is necessary. Then read the thumbnails and store it in a cell as follows. Calculate the number of thumbnails. So now we have to resize each thumbnail to make it a tail. Since we had previously calculated thumb size, now multiplying that to output scales would normalize all the thumbnails and results in a size of a tail. tiles and resized image is ready. Now we have to arrange these tiles into resized image. In order to perform that, we have to match each pixel of image with all the thumbnails and choose the close one considering color. In this block, we are taking average of each thumbnail. Next block is calculating a pixel of thumb size average and comparing that with every thumbnail average using distance formula that we talked earlier, and then saves the one with shortest distance into a cell. And the last block is just arrangement. First, select one pixel from each row and then concatenating all the pixels of that row here into a single cell. Then for first row, just copying same to mosaic, which the variable where we are storing the mosaic image. But for other than first row, we need to vertically concatenate each row to already created matrix. That is, if we consider second row that has been stored in current row, then in mosaic we already have first arranged row. Then what we want at second row? So we have to use vertically concatenation and so on for all other rows. Finally, display the result. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any queries, post them in the comments or get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing!